I'm Jyll, and I'm here with the Cancer Bats, and this is Liam and Scott. It's very nice to be here with you guys. You have a new album coming out. Tell me a little bit about that album.
New record, super psyched on it. Definitely, for us, like a lot heavier than our last record, so we're pretty excited about having like a real kind of gnarly album and a bunch of songs that I can't wait to play live.
What's your favorite song off that album?
I don't know. I'd say probably my favorite song on the record is Regret. It's got a fun, like, dancey kind of feel, and then a total, like, wicked riffy part. I don't know. It's like picking your favorite kid.
Yeah, it's kind of hard. I think as we're, like, touring now and playing the new songs live a little bit at a time, you know, we're kind of mixing up our set with old songs and new ones. So certain songs, like, you don't expect... maybe even just like the audience to like as much as you do. They're like, you know, this is my favorite song, and you know, you have ideas in your mind for what singles are going to be, and other people are like, oh, this is the best song, and they get really excited. So it's kind of cool to see that dynamic, you know, going from being in the studio and just being such like a focused idea, and then taking that and, you know, re-experiencing it.
So what are the major differences between your last album and this one?
I think with this record, when we went into the studio, we had a lot more of a specific idea for what we wanted to do, you know what I mean, the actual recording. So like a more of a focus on like guitars and guitar sound and drum sounds and, you know, bass tones and things like that this time around, versus just trying to capture the songs, you know what I mean, and sort of banging it out. This time we kind of stepped back a little bit more and was like, let's get the guitars to be really heavy. Like, let's get like a real bass presence, you know?
Yeah, like that. Not even just like the production side of it, like even just going into writing it, like the whole idea of having to write an album versus, you know, our first record was, you know, made up of roughly the first 11 songs that we'd written as a band. You know, some of those were, you know, off our demos, some of the first songs we'd ever written. And it's, as we were writing those, you know, we're discovering who we are as, you know, musicians and as a band. And I think with this time, like, gaining experience from the first record, we're now, I think, stronger songwriters. And so it allows us to then take things in other directions. So when we're like, okay, let's write a really heavy song, we know how to approach that properly without it just being a jumbled mess. It can be a really heavy song, but it can still be really catchy at the same time. It can have really interesting elements. And not just be like a mess of riff upon riff upon riff, which I think, you know, a lot of bands, including us, like when we first started, we just, you know, part after part, and now we're like, okay, how can we make anything a really good song? And just really learn how to criticize ourselves in a constructive way.
Yeah, and cool. Just be better songwriters. And I feel like we kind of got the idea of, like having all these riffs, but then knowing when to like stop and when to like kind of trim stuff down, and also to like, instead of just having part after part, like when to repeat things, do you know what I mean? To make more of like a cohesive, like, you know, verse, chorus, you know, type of idea. And which I think we were kind of like just learning how to do with Birthing the Giant, and having someone like Gavin Brown kind of show us how to do that, like on the first record.
Who's Gavin Brown?
Gavin Brown was the producer of Birthing the Giant. He's worked with bands like Billy Talent, 3 Days Grace, Melissa Auf-Demar, tons of stuff like that. So he's his strongest point is that he's a songwriter, and really good at that. So he kind of like showed us what to do, do you know what I mean, in a lot of ways, like, and gave us that confidence. So when it came time to doing our second record, we sort of knew a little bit more, you know what I mean, had a bit more of an idea of what we should be doing and not doing when it came to songs. And I feel like a lot of the songs on this record are stronger because of that.